अस्सलाम वालेकुम, आई एम डॉक्टर सुदीता आमिर फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ पीडियाट्रिक्स इंडिपेंडेंट मेडिकल कॉलेज फैसलाबाद। टुडेज टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज अबाउट विल्सन्स डिजीज व्हिच इज आल्सो कॉल्ड एज हेपेटोलेंटिकुलर डिजनरेशन। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डिस्कस द सिनेरियोस व्हिच यूजुअली कम्स इन यूनिवर्सिटी क्वेश्चंस। चिल्ड्रन विद डिफिकल्टी इन स्पीच एंड राइटिंग एसोसिएटेड विद पेलर एंड अबनॉर्मल लिवर फंक्शन टेस्ट एंड द सीजर्स। The first scenario is 13 years old boy came with the history of difficulty in speech and writing for last 4 years and also have difficulty in walking for last 1 year. There is difficulty to perform any work by hands for the last 6 months. His speech was also low volume, slurred and monotonous. Examination shows splenomegaly and there is a bilateral gynecomastia. Muscle stone was mildly increased and gait was limping. Slit lamp examination of eye revealed bilateral KF rings with normal visual acuity. This is MRI of this child. It shows hyperintensity and hypointensity in bilateral basal ganglia and putamen region, which is obvious in the scan. Normal MRI of the brain in patients with Wilson's disease. The next scenario is 11 years old boy came with a history of progressive pallor, lassitude, mildly jaundice for the last 2 months, dysarthria and excessive salivation. Examination shows pallor, jaundice, pulmonary erythema, hepatomegaly. There is postural tremor, dysgynekinesia, dysarthria, gait disturbances and KF ring is found on slit lamp examination of the eyes. This is the slide which shows the KF ring. This KF ring is 50% present in patients with liver disorder and it is 90% present in patients with involvement of neurological system. Next. The lab investigation shows low serum albumin level and there is an increased alanine transaminase. Ultrasound shows the hepatobiliary system reveals coarse hepatic ecotexture with splenomegaly. Liver scan shows non-uniform radio tracer distribution in the liver and there is an increased bony uptake. Additional lab investigations include serum ceruloplasmin level, which was more than 11.51 mg per dl, 24-hour urinary copper excretion was 150 microgram per day. 17 years old boy came with the history of seizures for the last 7 days, generalized tonic-clonic in nature. For last 2 days, he has multiple seizuring episodes without regaining conscious level. Prior history of behavioral disturbances in the form of disinterest in the surroundings, decreased interaction with friends and relatives, there is occasional outburst of temper for the last 4 months was present. Speech and gait difficulties for last 2 months, there was no history of headache, vomiting, visual disturbances or focal deficits. None of his siblings had similar illness. On examination, the child is vitally stable, there is no jaundice. Abdominal examination did not reveal any organomegaly or free fluid. On examination, KF ring is present in the cornea. Neurological examination shows mute having mask-like faces, drooling of saliva and dystonic tongue. There is generalized cogwheel rigidity in all the 4 limbs including the axial musculature. There is postural tremors of both upper limbs. Hyperreflexia with extensor plantars with normal muscle strength, sensory and the cerebellar system examination was unremarkable. Ophthalmological examination shows KF ring on slit lamp examination. Diagnosis in all the cases is Wilson's disease. About the Wilson's disease, the first and important thing is this is basically a autosomal recessive disorders. Means in most of the cases there is a family history of Wilson's disease and it involves multiple organs of the body. It shows degenerative changes in the brain, there is involvement of the liver and there is a KF ring that is seen in the cornea. This slide shows the autosomal recessive inborn error of copper transport, in which you will see that one patient is having Wilson's disease, two of them are the healthy carriers and one is healthy non-carrier. Incidence is 1 in 50,000 to 1 lakh births. The abnormal gene for Wilson's disease is present on chromosome 13. The gene encodes amino acid structurally consistent with the role in the copper binding transporting P-type ATPase. It is basically related to decreased excretion of biliary copper, which is get deposited in different parts of the brain, and it is due to the lysosomal defect in the liver cells. This diagram shows the intake and excretion when it is well balanced. Normal absorption and distribution of the copper is shown in this slide. Pathogenesis, there is a defective mobilization of copper from the lysosomes in the liver. It causes the accumulation of copper in the liver and patient is presenting with liver disorders. And when it get deposited in other organs, then it damage these organs like brain and other parts of the body. Copper that escapes the liver then damage the other organs, and there is a lipid peroxidation of the mitochondria. Clinical manifestations for liver. It may be just asymptomatic hepatomegaly with or without splenomegaly, may be a subacute or chronic hepatitis, or may be the fulminant hepatic failure. It may present as a portal hypertension, cirrhosis, ascites, edema, and variceal bleeding. Other effects on hepatic functions are delayed puberty, amenorrhea, and coagulation defects. Regarding the neurological and psychiatric disorder, there is intention tremors, dysarthria, dystonia, and there is a deterioration in school performance or behavioral changes. There is hemolysis, which may be manifest as Pancoli's anemia. In the initial slides, we show that they have a pallor along with the jaundice. Unusual manifestations include arthritis and endocrinopathies like hypoparathyroidism. Diagnosis, that if the child is having unexplained acute or chronic liver diseases, also having neurological manifestation, which we already discussed in details, there is acute hemolysis, psychiatric illnesses along with behavioral changes, there is Pancoli syndrome, unexplained bone diseases. Test performed for the diagnosis of Wilson's disease, it includes urinary copper level, serum copper level, serum ceruloplasmin level, KF rings, liver copper, Coombs negative, hemolytic anemia, and biochemical indices, MRI, and the molecular diagnosis. The best screening test is to measure the serum ceruloplasmin level. Serum copper level is more than 100 microgram per day and often up to 1000 microgram or more per day. The most important is the liver biopsy, but it is a bit invasive procedure. It involves the examination of the histology and measurement of the hepatic copper content. Usually, normally normal patient, it is less than 10 microgram per kg in dry weight. Screening for family members, as we discussed, this is autosomal recessive disorder and there is a states of healthy carrier, that's why we need screening. It includes serum ceruloplasmin level and urinary copper excretion. The first sign which usually appear is, first it involves the hepatic in 40% of the cases, neurological manifestation in 35% of the cases, and it may involve psychiatric, renal, hematological and endocrine disorders. Wilson's disease patient before treatment reduced excretion and the retention, which we already discussed all this in detail. Treatment of Wilson's disease include the copper chelating agents, that is oral administration of penicillamine. Wilson's disease patient on chelating therapy enhance the urinary excretion of the copper. Toxic effects of penicillamine. It may cause hypersensitivity reaction, interaction with collagen and elastin. There is a deficiency of other elements such as zinc, may present as aplastic anemia and the necrosis. the patients who are unable to tolerate penicillamine, there is a under trial studies of triethylene tetraamine dihydrochloride. Zinc is also given as an adjuvant therapy in patients with Wilson's disease. Zinc acetate is given in adults at the dose of 20 to 50 mg 3 times a day. Wilson's disease patient on zinc therapy enhance the fecal excretion of the copper. Foods such as liver, shellfish, nuts and chocolate should be avoided in patients with Wilson's disease. Untreated patients with Wilson's disease have a bad prognosis. They may die due to hepatic, neurological, renal or hematological complications. The prognosis for patients receiving prompt therapy of penicillamine is variable and depends upon the time of initiation of penicillamine and individual responsiveness. The modality ultimate which we required in patients with Wilson's disease is liver transplant, and it should be considered in patients if the child is having fulminant hepatic failure or decompensated cirrhosis or having progressive neurological disease. In asymptomatic siblings of affected patient, early start of chelating therapy can prevent the expression of the disease. Wilson's disease, if routine liver function tests are abnormal in a child, then consider Wilson's disease. If the child is having hemolysis but it is Coombs negative, then suspect Wilson's disease. Changes in mood or school performance in the teenagers with slurring of the speech, we have to rule out the Wilson's disease. This is the slide shows Wilson's disease deposited in the liver, bones, kidneys, heart, eye, brain, and also involve the hematological system. Thank you. Jazakallah.